heat transfer by conduction. This is a heat transfer mechanism wherein heat flows from a hotter part of the body to a colder part of the body through solid. Consider this block which has a cross-section area A through which heat power flows Q, which is given by the heat power Q by the cross-section area A. The hotter surface is at T1, colder surface is at T2, and the thickness of the block is delta X. Now Q is given by H into T1 minus T2, which is obtained from basically H into delta T relationship, the thermal coefficient relationship, where H is the thermal coefficient. Now there is another parameter K which is defined in the literature and in the physics tables. This is called thermal conductivity. Thermal conductivity is defined as thermal coefficient H into delta X. Delta X is the thickness of this block or the length of the block which is along, measured along the heat flow direction, watt per degree Kelvin per meter. So therefore H thermal coefficient is given by thermal conductivity K by delta X. So substituting K by delta X here, you will find the specific power Q is equal to K delta T by delta X. Now this is the heat flow rate equation or the Fourier law. If you multiply it throughout by the cross section area of the block, you will obtain Q, which is K into A into delta T by delta X. And from here you can see that R theta, the thermal resistance, is nothing but delta X by Ka. Now observe that the thermal resistance is inversely proportional to A, the cross-section area orthogonal to the flow of heat power. So greater the cross-sectional area, smaller will be the thermal resistance and better will be the heat conduction through that material. So in heat sinks, the reason why they have the convoluted fins is basically to increase the cross-sectional area normal to the flow of heat power without increasing the volume too much. So therefore the fins actually give a much greater cross-sectional area, and as a result the heat sinks have low thermal resistance. So greater the area, better will be the thermal resistance, lower will be the thermal resistance. So this relationship Q is equal to Ka delta T by delta X, where R thermal resistance, R theta, is equal to delta X by Ka. Delta X by Ka is a very important relationship in the heat transfer by conduction. So heat transfer by conduction, this is what normally literature uses, where K here is called the thermal conductivity, thermal coefficient into delta X. Now it is a material property, so K is equal to 410 in watt per degree Kelvin per meter for silver. It is 385 for copper, 211 for aluminum, 47.6 for steel, 1.05 for glass. You see, it is so low for glass. That is why glass is a good thermal insulator. Still better, thermocol, which you would have normally found in packing material, and it is actually polyurethane, is 0.025 for thermocol. And still layer 0.026. So you see that still air, thermocol, glass are all very good thermal insulators. So, and at the higher side where K has a large value, they're all very good conductors of heat. So where you want the heat to be conducted quickly with as little impedance as possible, you have to use thermal conductivity values which are higher. And if you want to retain the heat, you don't want the heat to conduct out, you have to pack it with materials having low thermal conductivity.